with On Air with Tony Sweet, only on Universal Broadcasting Network.
Oh! Yay! Yay! Well, this is one of my favorite subjects to be rubbed in my face, that I'm single and I can't find anybody to marry me. So, saying that, I'm here with Pamela Spires.
Who's not getting married.
You're not getting married?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, Zoe.
And Zoe's not getting married either. Maybe, she's too young.
She's too young.
Maybe she's had offers,
maybe
though.
I'm desperate. Yeah. And Zoe, please. Well, we have in studio two lovely couple.
Yes.
I mean, just a lovely couple here. And they're getting married. Yes. This coming, what's it, Monday?
Monday.
The 22nd of June.
Yes.
And we have them in studio. We have Paige. Why do I say Peggy?
I don't know.
It kind of looks like that.
No. It's Paige Hemmis, right?
Yes.
And Jason Short is in the house.
You said the names right.
I know.
And then I didn't have to Greek them up.
Usually she has to fix it for me where I'm
when
like,
when Debbie's here, it's easy. It's already Greeked up.
Right. Well,
I
you guys.
I love that clapping, by the way.
Is it great?
What
it's
clapping?
The audience. You don't know you're being watched. You are being watched.
It's
behind
so fabulous.
This wall, it's
all
a whole audience.
There.
Yeah. It's like one of those fake glass, you know?
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for being here.
And thanks for having us.
Well,
it's
of course.
Great.
And, you know, getting ready for a wedding can be crazy.
Let alone on national TV.
But on national TV, it's even more. So tell us the process of what you guys are going through now, less than a week away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I mean, I'm getting pretty nervous, that's for sure. But the house is pretty packed at the moment. We've got people from all around the world. So,
wow.
We've got, 18 people in the house at the moment.
Oh,
so.
Wow.
16 humans. And then we've got five animals.
It's
so.
A zoo.
Yeah.
It's a zoo.
Oh, my gosh. What's more well-behaved, the animals or the humans?
Thinking the animals. No. The dogs.
Yeah.
The rest of them are potty trained, so house trained. Are you from Georgia? No, I'm just kidding.
I get that a lot.
Can you tell?
The Gold Coast in Australia.
Awesome. I've never been to Australia, and that's one place I want to go.
I love Australia.
Amazing.
All right. Well, before we get into the... I want to know, tell us from the beginning where you met, how you fell in love.
Yeah.
That's always what people are interested in, because like people like me, I need to find out how to fall in love and find that person. Okay, here we go.
Now, here's how you do it. I was working on a show called Extreme Makeover Home Edition. Mm-hmm. And our season 5 finale was about heroes, and it was Hurricane Katrina and all that.
I remember that.
It was about midway. We went for 10 seasons, so it was about midway through. And I heard that the Ten Tenors, this Australian vocal group, was coming to sing a song about heroes.
Wow.
And as I sat there, I'm like gross in my tool belt, and all of a sudden there's
that's
like
great.
10 good-looking Aussie boys.
Oh, wow.
But I locked in on tenor number 3.
Yeah.
This one right here.
That's
yes.
Awesome.
I actually thought there was a spotlight over you.
Yeah.
But there was one. Yes.
Heaven's I know, really.
Yeah. Yes. And we actually have our first meeting. We have it on video on TV. So it's kind of cool
neat.
That we're also getting married on TV.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
a good bookend. But we actually have that video kind of like getting to know us on my website if you want to check it out. PaigeHemmis.com.
Yeah.
You can see our little... first meeting.
I think that's great, though.
It is fun.
You never know when the lightning's going to strike, the love bug's going to strike, and I think that's what a lot of people, they keep go in with their blinders on, and so they can't see a lot of opportunities.
I dissed Jason.
Did you really?
It may not have happened, you know. When we were in New Orleans, we were only there very briefly with the tennis. We had to fly out, so I didn't get to talk to her too much, but... I was heading back to Australia and came through LA, and I thought, you know, I've been on an 8-month tour. A couple of extra days is not a problem.
Right.
So I called her up and actually called her up on her birthday and said, happy birthday. And then
you're forgetting
her.
The 14 other calls that happened the night I met you.
She always.
Oh, here we go.
Story.
Here we go.
More
story.
Every time. You know?
14, not that you were counting, right?
Next week will be 20.
20
calls.
Exactly. Amanda understands me.
Yeah.
And so I called her up and said, would you like to go and see Wicked in here in LA at the Pantages? So all of a sudden, her schedule cleared up.
There you go.
And that was basically our first date.
Yeah.
We've been together for the past 7 years.
That's so great.
7 years, yep.
Mm-hmm.
And what took you 7 years?
Seriously, we probably still wouldn't be getting married unless it was on the show. Yeah. We're like, yeah, things are fine. Like,
Aussies don't rush into these sorts of things, you know. We just get engaged, give it some time, and then when the time's right, which it is now, I'm very happy and excited about it too. So,
well, you said that because a lot of people, they say once that paper says we're married, things change. What are you nervous about that?
We actually, our wedding program that everyone will see, it's a company called 20 Pages, and it's awesome because it's like a little magazine about us. Mm-hmm. But they asked us that question, and they said, what will change after you're married? And he put Paige's last name. And they said, what else? Nothing.
Oh, that's great. I mean, I think if you go into it with that attitude, it's not going to change. I think sometimes what I've seen is that it's when all that thought goes into things are going to change, things are going to change, right. It's not going to be the same. It's like you've put so much into it, you've created something that doesn't even exist, but now it exists because you just created it.
It's unnecessary pressure.
It's not exactly, so you just have to move forward.
Yes, yep, and it's, you know, like being together and, oh, I mean, we don't live together and we're very virtuous. We're going to wait till we get married.
What? All right. Yeah. That's,
No, we might already be living together.
Yeah, I was going to say, wait a minute, that was your house I saw in photos. Yeah. Didn't say anything about Paige's house.
Whoops.
That slipped out.
12 years of Catholic school coming out right there.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. But yeah, it's just, I think for us, it's just going to be growing the relationship we already have. Mm. And I hope nothing changes. I'm having a great time.
Exactly. It won't change because you're not going to let it.
Good.
You wouldn't have it any other way.
That's my little
motto.
I like
Don't have it any other way.
Yeah. Well, right? I want to know how did the TV opportunity come up?
Who roped you into this? Was it Debbie?
Her name. Debbie's actually our wedding coordinator.
I know.
Kind of Debbie.
Yeah, she talked a lot about you guys on this show.
I love Debbie. I give her such
love
a
Debbie.
Hard time.
Yeah.
We're like sisters. But yeah.
You guys look like sisters, actually.
I do.
Yeah. Oh, my dad passed away a few months ago.
But I'm sorry.
Thank you. But he the week before he died, he's like, you have never looked better as when you were watching. And he said the name, and I wasn't on that show. It was Debbie.
It was Debbie.
I'm like,
that's hilarious.
Thank you. Dad, thank you so much. That means so much more. Like, you've never looked better. Thanks, Debbie. Thanks
well,
for that.
Debbie was named as one of the, I don't even know if she knows this, she was one of the sexiest Greeks. Did you know this? I have to send you the link from Greek Getaway. And
really?
I came across it when I saw the announcement of Insider for her, and I saw it and I'm like, wow. And so she's in there with, you know, Maria Menounos, of course, and John Stamos and Jennifer Aniston and Debbie.
Wow.
And she's really, so I'm like, wow. She's also one of the sexiest Greeks.
One of the sexiest Greeks. So I will happily take that.
I know.
It's always good when they compare you to somebody that you actually think is attractive.
Yeah. That made the 100 worst.
So let's get back to who roped you into this.
Yeah. Can I digress there?
Mark? Christina?
It was Stacy. Tyler's mom. Yeah. So Woody Fraser, the show's creator, it was his daughter.
Oh, really?
And these guys, Jason and his group, Aria, they performed on our Christmas special. And they were like, oh, we're doing a wedding special in the spring. Would you guys be interested? And we're like, sure. And then it was just a big joke. We're like, ha, ha, ha. You know, we thought they were kidding. And then
so it just kind of went with it.
Yeah, when it came down to it, though, we really had to think about the decision a lot because you're sharing it with a lot of people. So we talked for a while about it. But I guess the thing that made it easiest in the end was having all of our family there, and it's something extremely special for them. It's,
I bet,
who gets married on television doesn't happen every day. So.
No, it's great.
Yeah, we had to change our plans a little because his family is from Australia and mine's from LA and Wisconsin and Chicago. Mm-hmm. We were going to meet in Hawaii because it's kind of like halfway.
Oh, destination.
So, so we kind of had to tell the family, like, how do you feel about not going halfway? Mm-hmm. Going just a little further to Los Angeles. But they're excited. I mean, they all got here on Monday, and we've been having so much fun with the full house. We had a meet and greet barbecue.
Oh, how fun. That sounds cool.
Yes.
You bring any?
It's been fun. It's been fun watching on the show, too. And I think I heard something about you. I know this was on the show. So are you going to be singing at your wedding? That's so amazing.
We're going to bring a bit of Hawaii to the wedding.
Oh, that's great.
Israel Kamaka Wewa Ole's version of Over the Rainbow we're going to do.
Oh,
so.
Wow. That's going to be
great. That's right.
That's going to be great. So is it an acapella group or is it?
No, we played a track or band
That's great. Okay. I'll have to check it out.
It's very exciting. It's been fun watching the Hallmark Channel and how they've really been hyping this. I mean, it's huge. I mean, it's really the wedding that you want to do, to watch. And it's, and they've fallen in line with the whole, you know, June weddings, which has been great because there's so many new movies that are coming out this month, too. And you guys fall in line with, it's all about weddings and brides and, you know, and it falls in line with everything that's happening in the world. Everybody gets married in June, it seems like. Except for Greeks. They have to get married on the islands in the, you know, August and when it's hot and everybody's sweaty and the grandmothers are, and, you know, riding on the donkeys. And
oh, that sounds fun.
We were talking about getting all the bridesmaids together and watching like a couple chick flicks, which Hallmark is great for. They've got all these wedding shows. And
it's
so we're going to learn what the do's and don'ts by watching some movies. So. We have a girls' night planned for that.
It's fun. Hallmark Channel, I think, has done an incredible job at promoting your wedding, but also the June weddings theme and everything like that. And I think it's great that Home and Family just has embraced this in such a way. Being on set, obviously, I was there with my sister on Monday, which was really, really great. And her going and doing the makeover, and then he just hearing the hype about the wedding. Everything was about the wedding, the wedding. They're going to have meatballs. Okay. You know,
it's like, meatballs, but it's like, there.
Yeah. And then, but everything, it's really cool because everything on the set, but it's everybody there, everybody behind the scenes and everybody that's hosts and part of the show and part of all the family members. It just seems like it's such an incredible opportunity for everybody to be part of this. So how does that make you both feel? I mean, you've got a lot of people just like all over it.
Yeah, there is so much that goes into something like this, and a lot of times that's missed and not seen. And I think we're extremely grateful, obviously.
Well, and the amount of talent that is in that place, it is, I mean, we've got the best DIYers in America, and they're all contributing to the wedding, and so it's so cool. I look around, and it's kind of like ideas that we had, you know, Ken or Tanya, for instance, they'll say, I see your idea. I'm going to make it a little better.
Yeah.
And they find some way to make it better, and so I'm so excited to
see
how it all
comes
together.
Your chairs are cool. I saw that. Was that yesterday or today? I can't remember when I saw the chairs or something?
Chair swag?
Yeah.
That, it's so, like, every little detail is just so beautiful. And
it's awesome.
Above and beyond anything we would have done. We would have gone to Costco and bought it. We need some beer in a backyard somewhere in Hawaii. So this is awesome that it's going to be so amazing.
Okay, so I'm digging the American flag on the Aussie over there. What's the story on that one?
He wanted to steal California
love.
Yeah,
I've got one of these California love hats.
Uh-huh. You want the pink one?
Well, I've got the man version, I guess.
Yeah.
The man version. And, you're California, that could be both, yeah.
I know.
I could have been the same hat as her. That would be cool. So
no.
I'm with the American flag. But, you know, I live here now, so.
I love it. That's great.
That's
awesome.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, you know, most people, when they say traditional wedding, what is traditional wedding to you? And then what, you said they're going to even make it bigger and better. What's it going to be like, this big surprise? I mean, you don't have to give it all the way, but just give us some teaser of what we're expecting.
It's pretty amazing. They my dream was to have a backyard wedding, and it just so happens we work on a set that looks like a house and does have a backyard. But from there, just because I was like, what about if we do little twinkly lights or this and that? And so Ken, one of the things he's doing is taking wine bottles and mason jars and putting lights in them and putting them all over the backyard. And he said, how many were you thinking? I was like, 10, 12. He's like, we have 250. so things like that. And I love using fabrics. And they said, like, okay, we'll drape some fabrics here. And they just kept going and going and going.
Oh my gosh.
Expanded.
Yeah.
Yes, they put up a new trellis. So every day we can kind of see new stuff appearing in the backyard.
Yeah.
Like, don't look.
Oh, I was just going to say, do they let you look or no?
It's still kind of, because we're still filming a TV show.
Right.
So it's still like in
it's
pods
there.
Almost.
Yeah.
Like
it's
contained, but I sneak out there and look.
Yeah, of course you want to see it. It is your wedding.
Yes.
Well, talk about, you know, they say it's hard to find a photographer or videographer for a wedding. Mm-hmm. So this is the best thing that anybody could ever have.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Is having,
just send the link to everybody.
Yeah, one of those.
Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, someone said that to us the other day. Do you have a videographer? I'm like, yes, six and a jib. So I think we're good.
Now, are celebrities attending or outside of the family, the home family?
Yes and no. for the actual ceremony, we had to keep it small because it's on the set of Universal. So we're having an after party that we're looking forward to. And then we get to invite all our celebrity friends and do that. But right now, it was such a limited number that it's really only family and the family members on Home and Family. Yeah. So I'm excited for the after party, too. So we're going to party away on the set, and then we're going to go somewhere else for the after party. And
That's great.
Really party.
That's great. That's great.
Well, I want to go back a little bit, working on Extreme Home Makeover. Tell us about working on that.
So fun.
Amazing. Yeah, I mean, because I used to watch it all the time. And I think it was, you know, half the time or 90% of the time you walk away in tears because of people's stories. What was it like on set? Did people actually get that emotional on set?
Oh, I left. I was in medicine. I left medicine because I was crying too much. I was, you know, working with sick people. I'm like, I'm going to go into something. There's no tears. Real estate. Like, for sure, I'm not going to cry in real estate. And every week.
You learned up on this show.
Oh, yeah. Every week. It was so emotional. And,
I cry every time I watch that show.
Yes. And then I would, and I knew, I was there. I knew what happened. And I'd watch the episode and I'd be crying through watching it, too. Like, I know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
But still, it gets you. And
of course.
But what an amazing opportunity.
Yeah. Even the family stuff aside with Extreme, being on set and watching that, you see these houses go up in 5 days sometimes, even quicker than that.
It's insane. Yeah, I mean, I often wonder, like, my sister and I went, come on, you know, they took longer than that. But no, we hear, and I think I heard you talk about it once too. You're like, no, that's how long it took. And
yeah, it takes less. Yeah. We say 7 days, but it took five.
Yeah, wow.
Come back the next day, there's a roof on it. Come back.
Yeah.
It's drywall.
Yeah. Well, you see, like, some of these contractors take like months and months and months. And
we're doing it. We flip houses. And
you do?
And like, our quickest flip has been, what, a year and a half?
Like, that's the quickest?
Yes. Like, that's how long it takes when you're doing it yourself. While, when you've got 4,000 people helping.
Yeah.
That makes sense. You can do it pretty quick. Yeah.
And you said you grew up in the Midwest?
I'm from Wisconsin, but my mom moved here when she said she was old enough to not shovel snow anymore. Yeah. That's when she moved out here. She's like, I'm not doing it.
Yeah.
Staying in California.
That's why I'm from Kansas, so I know.
Yeah.
And so you're from Australia, and I want to know about the group a little bit, because I've not heard of the group.
Yeah.
So I'm excited. I'm a musician myself, so that's why I'm excited about hearing about yours.
Yeah, we, the four of us that used to be in the Ten Tenors, met American girls, and now we're out here. So we thought, let's not just sit around.
That was a successful trip.
let's put a group together. And, and so we created ARIA. And we've been kind of sticking to the corporate realm. We did a lot of touring with the Ten Tenors. So all around the world. We were lucky enough to go to, you know, 25, 30 countries.
Wow.
During the time I was with them. And we thought, let's get something started here. And then ARIA formed, and we've just been going around the country doing corporate stuff at the moment. We released our album, actually, on the Christmas special last year on Home and Family. Home, we named it, just kind of worked with the
other ones. So your next one's Family.
Yeah. We have
next time we'll be doing a baby shower, right?
Look at her face. Like, wait a minute. He's carrying it.
We will release Over the Rainbow after the wedding happens.
Great.
And ARIA actually stands for, it's an acronym for Aussies Reunited in America.
And there's the ARIA Awards in Australia too. There's all these things that sort of tie in. Hopefully we'll get a gig at the ARIA Casino.
What's the website? What, do you have a website?
Yeah, www.aria4.com.
I can't wait to hear some of your music.
It's amazing. And I hear it every day, but still every time. It's like being on Extreme Makeover. Like, I start crying. I'll start with chills. By the end of the song, I'm crying.
Well, and it was like being on the show with my sister. And then, like, it was us telling the story, which, you don't, you know, we're very private. And so it was saying, all of a sudden it hit us, I think the night before, we're like, oh my God, we're going to tell our story. And Nashville, what are you, crazy? We barely tell anybody our story. And so it was pretty amazing.
Feel the love when you share it with that
such
many people?
An amazing, well, and Debbie said that, I guess there's been a lot of feedback and that people really connected with my sister and I. And my sister, what I really wanted is not only for my sister to gain from it and to realize how worthy she is and what her purpose is, but also for so many caregivers. We wanted the message out there so that caregivers knew that they have an incredible, probably more worthy than a lot of us, and an incredible purpose on earth as well. So it was really, really amazing to see her smile and smile. She doesn't stop smiling. Debbie's follow up has been
so
amazing.
Good.
Just keeps checking on her and letting her know, and the feedback she's been getting from everybody. So it just, it was a very emotional thing. I cry on those things anyway, let alone it being my sister.
Well, and
it was our mom's birthday yesterday. And so it was just all this reuniting of things and remembering.
The amazing thing about your sister is that she didn't expect anything, and,
right.
and she's not used to asking for things for
Never.
Herself.
She doesn't.
So
yeah.
it was so wonderful to see mm-hmm. people shower her. At first, she didn't know what to do.
I know.
She was looking around
like
what am I
doing?
Yeah, what am I doing? And then after a while, she just let everyone do
she
their
did,
thing.
Didn't
and,
she?
Yeah,
I was
she
neat.
Settled in.
Yeah.
I think she might be addicted.
I think she said, oh, I'd do it again. And then she would never, she was on the show earlier today at 4. She was our first guest. And so normally she would have never, ever done this show. And she was like, yeah, I'll do it. I was like,
real
oh,
she's pro. A pro.
Okay.
She's a pro.
Yeah.
I mean, who doesn't like getting pampered? I mean, come on.
Yeah.
I love it.
It was. But you know what, though? But my sister never really accepted that. She wouldn't.
Really?
Well, and she had the other thing about, you know, she wouldn't go into hair salons after mom died because she always took mom with her. She was doing the box dye. So all that Brianna was, you know, who mm-hmm. did her hair was, and that's all true stories.
Yeah.
So we hope we connected to caregivers out there. But I think Home and Family does a great job with just bringing out the, not just the joys of weddings, but also the reality of what happens in everyday life and all of those things put together. So it's really great. But we're excited because the next big show, to me, is your wedding, which,
Yeah.
So Monday to Monday was a really cool. My Sharon's makeover Monday, and now your wedding next Monday. So Monday's our favorite day.
I want to know. You say all your family's here, but what was it? What was the family reaction? Parents' reaction? Like, you're gonna do it on TV?
Yeah.
My
side of the family embraced it. They were excited about it, and nervous too.
Yeah.
I suppose, but yeah, they took the good side of it.
And they think Hollywood is so glamorous.
Yeah, so they're probably eating this up. Yeah, they're probably eating it up. Yeah,
it's glamorous. Yeah,
it might get a little too hard here. How the whole process goes.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, so one of the other common things that I have with Debbie is the fact that. My boyfriend, who's sitting in the green room, Tony Costas, right now, he did the Zabekiko dance at Gabby Awards, and I guess Debbie saw him and said, "Oh my God, you do the best Zabekiko dance," which is basically the drunk man's dance, is what we call it in Greek, because everybody's just like, you know, looks like you're.
Oh my God!
You know,
I also have one of those in my
family.
And so
Debbie saw him dancing, said it's the best one that she's ever seen since her father passed away, and so I'm going to offer Tony to do that dance at your wedding if you'd like him to.
Yes, please.
Because Debbie said she's going to add something Greek to that wedding.
Yes. If it could be a drunk man dancing, that would be perfect.
See, there you go. Tony's not really drunk at the moment, but he does a really good job at just like doing the whole thing. He puts the ouzo on his head and everything. It's great.
Ouzo!
I know.
All right. Where's the honeymoon going to be? Do we know yet?
We haven't really had time to plan one yet.
Yeah, we sort of.
Oh, you're kidding.
Comes, you know?
Oh, come on.
Like
it's going to be revealed on the show.
We don't know.
Hell yeah, yeah. I'll bet it's going to be revealed on the show. Come on.
My goal after the wedding is to just stare at a wall for like a good day.
I'm sure. Yeah, you probably will. Yeah, you'll be like probably plastered to the wall with your eyes shut.
Yeah, I mean, we've only had 3 months to plan, which is how I work anyway. I like to do things on the fly.
Right.
But packing all this into 3 months is, it's been a challenge. So just like today, I'm like, did we pay our bills? Oh no, we haven't done that in a while.
Yeah. We haven't done that in a while.
Seriously, on the way here, I'm like, my credit card's not working. It's all the like normal human things you forget
have time to do
when you're planning a wedding.
Right.
It's a full-time job.
Of course,
some people could assume that because it's on television.
Right, everything's being taken care of.
It's almost, they have to ask us anyway, right?
Sure.
We've got to go through more people now instead of making a decision ourselves. But it's still a great process, really enjoying it.
Yeah, they make it fun.
They do.
Yeah. And the fact that, because normally I do DIYs on the show, and so normally the night before I'm building something, you know, we have to bring in a hero that's already done, and then we show how to do it on the show. And this has been so exciting because it's just been other people contributing to the wedding. So I'm like, yay, I don't have to do anything the night before.
Yeah.
I get to show up and be surprised.
Yeah.
And it's kind of fun. Like, kind of like with your sister, I completely connected with her, the fact that, like, I'm not used to receiving help. I DIY.
Right.
I do it myself.
Yes.
Yeah. Always. So it's kind of weird. Mm-hmm. It was really hard at first. Mm-hmm. Now I'm getting very used to it.
Yeah. I think my sister is too. I kind of got a little bit of a diva-ish bit when she was sitting in there, and I don't think I've ever seen a diva happen with my
sister
before.
She walked in, she goes, I need my throne.
Yeah, she did say something like that, didn't she? I also, on the show, I heard the one that we were there for, that you're vegan. Are you vegan or you just have special...
I'm allergic to shellfish and chicken.
Okay.
So it seems like I'm vegan. Yeah, okay. Because I used to do
more.
Everything.
Do you do more of a vegan diet?
I tried for 30 days. Sophie Uliano on our
yes.
show.
Yeah, yes.
She put us on a strict...
Did you, did you do her 30 day?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Great.
He and lost 15 pounds. Yeah. 15 I think I lost pounds. Two. Mm-hmm.
Two. Oh, really?
Wow. We're on the same plan.
I just cut out dairy and
Sophie
said I had to cut
awesome.
Out beer, but that hasn't gone so well.
He just cutting out the dairy. Yeah.
Well, speaking of Sophie, who you've got to get on the show. We've said that. I think we say that all the time. She's someone who we've supported. Well, Earth Friendly Products, one of my clients, has supported because she's, so
she's
vegan
green.
And green and all of those things. And this is a good time to share the fact that this basket at the end of the table is a wedding gift to you from on behalf of our CEO, Kelly Vlahakis Hanks, and everyone from Earth Friendly Products.
Huge.
We want to wish you a very happy, happy wedding.
Thank you so much.
We hope it's green and clean and lots of fun.
Oh, my gosh. It's just amazing.
Well, people in the
house,
too.
And that should take care of cleaning your house after you get rid of all those 18 people.
Yeah.
So a happy, happy wedding to you, and we wish you all the best.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Thanks. But I noticed that you have dogs, too, and cats. So we'll have to, in addition to this, we'll send you a gift basket with our pet line as well.
Oh,
we have a phenomenal Earth-friendly pet line as well. So we'll send you that gift as well.
That's so wonderful. Yeah. They're our kids, until we do have our kids. Or if.
I get it. I get it. I mean, she even shows up. Zoe's awake now.
Ours are 90 pounds, though. They're not quite lap dogs like Zoe is.
Well, my sisters, Sharon has two boxers. One's 55 pounds and one's a little bit, just almost 60 maybe. And they think they're lap dogs. They sit on her lap as if they are 9 pounds. And so they are pretty comical. So we get that. Yeah,
ours try.
Yeah.
They do.
Yeah.
They try.
I love that you're dog people.
So tell us, after the wedding's over, what do we have to look forward to? For what?
Nothing.
Any more television
Staring
stuff?
Staring at the wall. No. I'm going to continue on Home and Family. I'll go back to doing my DIYs, which I'm really excited to do. It's been so fun doing wedding stuff. But we're builders. We want to get back into it. And Jason wasn't a builder.
Mm-hmm. Got the hammer going. Oh.
Yeah, she got me into all of it. I'm
That's
absolutely
great.
Loving it.
So are you gonna team up for the show now, or
he's gonna sing
while
they build.
That's up to the show.
Yeah, sing while you work.
Yes.
While you work, sing while you work. Whatever.
They do it. They do it. Him
it's
and
a big bear flip we're working on at the moment.
Yeah. Him and Scotty, who is one of his bandmates, they do, and they don't realize they're singing, but it's like in harmony. It's like opera singing, and they're they both got tool belts on. It's really fun just to watch.
That's a
reality show right there. Do you start singing with them and then she's like,
that's what he would say.
Yeah, he's like, shh.
No, I
know how bad of a singer I am. I keep my place.
For me, that's what I'll be doing. Going back to the hammer.
We're taking a couple months off.
Do you have any performances coming up?
We'll probably go back into the studio. We want to release another album by the end of this year. So we'll get started on that.
Do you write your own?
We're still in cover land at the moment, but we were definitely on this next album. We'll put a couple of originals on it.
Oh,
a few people are going to write for us, and we'll put some together ourselves. But very much looking forward to that. We like being in the studio, staying at home, and
they built it.
Built it. Yeah. Oh my god,
it's really legit too. It's
I was sad. That's awesome. I had just gotten out of the hospital. My appendix went south. Oh. So I in my bed, they said I was on bed rest for 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. I could hear them building the studio, and so you hear hammer and nails.
And you're
and
like, I want
to
go.
I want to go down there. I want to go down there.
Oh,
did you grow up like building? Yeah. Or I mean,
no, my dad was a race car driver, so I know how to race cars and how to rebuild engines.
Really?
The new cars, not so much.
The old ones,
the old ones. But no, I started in real estate. And raised money to get my own rental properties and didn't have enough money to fix them up. Like have somebody actually fix them up. So
who would have thought they would have started a whole different career?
I know. I literally went to Home Depot and got Home Improvement 1, 2, 3, and I'm sitting there with the directions and figuring out how to do it myself.
Great.
But But it was
fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know my sister, we did a remodel for our family home because when my mother got ill, we were trying, you know, we wanted to switch things up and we knew we'd probably end up selling the family home, which we are. And so my sister took on, because she was the primary, she wasn't working. And so that was one thing that was kind of helped her with some, when she was focused on the project management of it. And so we wanted to do more ourselves, but we couldn't because we, you know, there just wasn't the time. But we did look at certain things, and she now wants to, she's thinking about this. She's thinking about, like, well, maybe I'll start flipping houses or something. She's looking at, she's, since us, you know, Monday, she's now looking at a really kind of more open about really focusing on her career, which is really cool, because that was one thing that Debbie just wanted to hear so much. And she heard it in an email, and then we got the most amazing email back from her to just,
that's
like,
so cool.
Yeah, touch my heart. But that is so cool to do those things. And I have no idea what direction I was going. There was a point that I was getting to, and I have no idea what it was.
DIY is so good it is. For the soul.
It is.
Really,
yes.
It's the accomplishment, you know?
Right. Yeah. Knowing that you did it with your own hands.
When I was a kid,
your hands created it.
I grew up in a small town in Kansas, and my dad owned a grocery store and a meat locker, so I was bored. And so I would go down to the lumber yard.
Where's the beef?
Yeah, and I would either get paint or lumber, and I'd charge it to my dad.
Yeah.
And so my dad would get home, and he's like, what are you doing? I'm like, oh, I'm building a deck. Oh, I'm painting a house. And he's like, oh, okay. And he would go in, have dinner, and then he'd come out and start working painting with me, or
cool.
I just always have loved to do that stuff. Yeah.
That it is a good way to connect with kids too. We kind we had a roundtable discussion on the Home and Family set about all of us and some of the people that we've brought into the DIY space that never thought they would be, like Matt Rogers, who also was a singer. I feel like him and Jason were the same, like had no interest in building, and all of a sudden we're like, here you go. Here, just take this. Let me have the microphone. Take a hammer.
Oh, that's great.
And they're both kind of addicted now, too.
Very addictive.
Yeah. When Jason, when we bought this Big Bear property it was like 2 months ago, he said, I want to do this flip. And I was like, I'm in the middle of planning a wedding. So I'll see you in 3 months.
Sounds like a man right there.
I know.
But he did. He's made a lot of progress.
That's great. Mm-hmm.
Good. All right, well, Jason Short, Paige Hemmis, we are so, so honored to have you on the show. Make sure you tune in to Hallmark Channel, Home and Family, June 22nd.
Are you ending this already?
Yeah, we have to go. I know.
I just want to keep going.
I know.
No, I'm so excited for the wedding.
Well, I can't. Maybe you guys can stop in afterwards
there you
and
go.
Come back and see
us.
You guys should come to the after party.
I would love to. I'm going to have to talk to this one here.
Yes. Put Sharon and I down. Oh, and Tony. He's going to have to do the dance, too.
Me?
No, the other Tony.
Oh,
okay. No. We don't want you. You can stick to the drinking. You drink?
No,
so
I
he
don't
can
drink,
get.
That's a problem.
That's why you don't.
I don't either.
That's right.
You don't either?
Yeah.
Do you drink?
I'll drink.
Oh, yeah.
He'll
drink. He's like, I'll do you.
I need to send you some ouzo.
So, pagehemmis.com?
Yep.
And then your band one more time?
aria4.com.
That's the...
Number four.
Not letter.
Yes.
All right. So we are on our Tony Suite. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we have Ann Walker in the house, going to talk about what's coming up. We'll talk about what's going on at Earth Friendly Products.
Yeah.
And make sure you tune in this coming Monday the 22nd.
Night.
And I think it's 8 p.m.
Yes.
Is it 7?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 8, 7, 6,
so
oh
exciting.
Gosh,
happy
exciting.
Marriage.
Thank you.
Happy marriage.
Thank you.
All right. Don't go anywhere on our Tony Suite on Universal Broadcasting.